If you are of the opinion that all women are weaker than men, then you better hope you never get into a fight with one of these ladies. While it is true that physically women are weaker than men, these women didn't follow the rules. Through hard work, endurance, and an incredible amount of determination, the women on this list have earned their title as a certified strong woman. Here are the strongest women in the world. Do you love powerful and interesting videos? Be sure to hit that subscribe button to get what you want. Brittany Diamond. What comes to mind when you think of a strong woman? Do you think of someone who was a tomboy growing up? Who can relate to Merida and Mulan more than Snow White and Cinderella? The type of girl who hates all things shiny and sparkly. I love people who break the mold. Ladies and gentlemen, meet Brittany Diamond, a 25-year-old Bostonian who loves lifting as much as humanly possible, and wait for it, pink and sparkly things. She is fairly young, but she is also out to prove that lifting and being strong is just as feminine as stockings and high heels. While she is still young, she is smashing records and placing extremely well at competitions. For example, in 2015, she placed 7th at the heavyweight division of the Arnold Strong Woman World Championships. This is impressive considering the division had 40 competitors from 25 different countries. Most of these women had been lifting for much longer than her and were more experienced. But in the world of athletics, determination is everything. She wants to be the strongest woman in the world, and it won't be long until we'll have to update this list with her name at first place. This woman could probably lift more than most men and in high heels. Not that she would, because that would be ill-advised, but I'm just saying that she probably could, okay? Kristen Rhodes. This is a lady who is hard to ignore. She is one of the biggest names on the women's bodybuilding circuit. She wins almost every competition she enters, and when she's first, the gap between first and second place is enormous. She has a massive amount of raw power that is only eclipsed by her passion for her sport. But this comes as no surprise since athleticism and power is in her blood. Her grandfather was a shot put champion, and her uncle was a professional medium distance runner. She grew up watching these dedicated men and took a few of those lessons to heart. She says that her biggest supporters are her children and her husband, and she is grateful that they love the sport just as much as she does. This one special lady who recognizes that her competitors have also worked hard can often be seen cheering on her fellow competitors and even giving them some tips. This shows an incredible amount of inner strength as well, and we are grateful that she knows how to keep things classy. In 2012, all her hard work paid off, and she represented the US in the World Championships in Finland, which we are happy to announce she won by a landslide. At age 41, she is still going strong and will probably still be lifting until the day she dies. It's always remarkable when you find the one thing in life that you're passionate about, and watching Kristen in action proves how dedicated she is to her calling. Jill Mills. Jill Mills is a strong woman icon. When little girl powerlifters look up after benching more than I can, they look up at a poster of Jill Mills. She is known as a pioneer in the strong woman division, and she has a passion for lifting that is enhanced by her talent and skill. In fact, she was the first woman to ever win the title as World's Strongest Woman back in 2001. She then succeeded herself the very next year and came third in 2005. She has been competing since 1991 and has touched many lives since then. She has been an inspiration for many and the standard to which most strong women hold themselves to. She is now a proud mother of two and has been happily married for some time now. She is living proof that a woman can achieve her dreams without having to sacrifice her personal life, which is a lesson that most of us can take to heart. She is also an example of how hard work and resolute can get you far in life. So it doesn't matter what your dreams are, whether it's being a strong woman or climbing Mount Everest, know that you can do it. I mean, if she can do it, then why can't you? Today the gym, tomorrow the World Strong Woman Championships. Or, you know, today the candy store, tomorrow Willy Wonka's chocolate factory. A girl can dream, right? Becca Swanson. Who says there is a competition between brains and brawn? In fact, Becca Swanson is a triple, brainy, brawny, and beautiful. She graduated from UNL in 1998 with a BS, or Bachelor of Science, in Mechanical Engineering. Eventually, though, she followed her heart to her true calling and now owns a very successful gym in Omaha, Nevada. You know that saying, jack of all trades, master of none? Well, guess what? She's a Jill of all trades. winner of strong woman and powerlifting competitions. Yeah, that saying is going to catch on like fire. One of her personal mottos is to live off of goals instead of inspiration, which makes sense since we get our own inspiration from our goals. Anything else is fairly temporary. She also says that a great lifter will never miss workouts, which means that I'm a terrible lifter. I'll try not to take it personally as I accidentally drive past the gym to Mickey D's. She shows dedication that comes from a deep love for her sport, and we must say that it is a wonder to watch her do what she does best. She almost inspires me to change my unhealthy ways. Almost. When asked about her future goals, she says she wants to wait for another girl to reach her total, then climb back in and smash past her total. You know, I feel as though she and I would have a lot in common, if it weren't for the insanely fit thing. Gemma Taylor Magnuson. Comes to mind when you think about the term power couple. Do you see visions of Jay-Z and Beyonce, or Kim Kardashian and Kanye West? Well, Gemma Taylor Magnuson and her husband Benedict Magnuson could probably lift both of those couples without breaking a sweat. At a touching ceremony where the world's best powerlifters watch the couple get married, the two lifters exchange barbells for rings, which is romantic, I'm told. A couple that lifts together stays together, or something like that. Then, after tiring of pulling lorries in competitions, she tried her hand at singing on The Voice. Sadly, she didn't make it through, but she entertained the audience and judges more when she lifted up will.i.am and Ricky Wilson. This was after will.i.am asked if she could beat him and Ricky up. After slight hesitation, she explained that she doesn't use her strength for violent purposes. After all, The Voice is all about showing off your talents, right? In all seriousness though, Gemma is one of the most talented bodybuilders out there. She has won many awards for her strength and knows just what she needs to get to the top. She may not have won the title of World's Strongest Woman, but she certainly is one of the more entertaining strong women. You go, Gemma! Lift that famous person! Chen Wei Ling. Born in 1982, this Taiwanese lifter is making powerful waves on the international bodybuilding circuit. She has won bronze at the Olympics and can lift up to 3 times her own body weight, which I'm sure qualifies her as a superhero. I mean, can you imagine trying to get the better of her in a fight? If you don't think that's impressive enough, she even set the record in squatting and deadlifting at the 2009 World Games. She represented Taiwan again at the Summer Olympics in 2016 and made her country proud. We know this is a bit premature, but we think she is one of the strongest women of all time, and definitely one of the most accomplished lifters on this list. Of course, after achieving what is every athlete's dream and representing her country at the Olympics, not once but 3 times, means that she can only go up from here. Since she is already sitting and watching us from dizzying heights, we cannot wait to see what the future holds for this tremendously talented lifter. And may I just point out that if there is a zombie apocalypse, it would be an extremely smart idea to be on her team. In fact, it is generally a good idea to be on her team anyway. Aneta Florczyk. This Polish powerhouse may not be the tallest woman on this list, but she has definitely broken the most records. She has won the title of World's Strongest Woman 4 times, she has been crowned as the European Strongwoman Champion 3 times, and she has set the Polish powerlifting record. Her success lies in the amount of preparation she does. She does not take her talent for granted and has worked very hard to be where she is now. She has competed in extremely prestigious lifting championships and has racked up quite the resume. That doesn't mean she's all work and no play, however. She has made several appearances on the Guinness World Records show and has set the record for rolling the most frying pans in 1 minute. It's 5 pans a minute for any of you curious cats out there. That's a hard number to beat, so you better start rolling some pans now if you want to beat that. I'm not sure where the pan-focused aggression comes from, but let's be honest, it is a useful skill. I'm not sure what you would use it for, but it is still impressive. And if you would like to fight me on this fact, just remember that Aneta also lifts men over her head. Seriously, she is currently working on breaking the record for most men benched overhead, which is an extremely useful skill, in my personal opinion. Judy Glennie. Rewind the clock about 30 or so years. The world is a very different place. Shoulder pads are in, and women bodybuilders are a figure of myths, seldom talked about and thought not to exist. Enter Judy Glenny. Married to a powerlifter and housing the strong desire to be a champion herself, she was instrumental in getting women's lifting accepted both nationally and internationally. You see, at this point, women didn't compete in powerlifting championships. There were no titles for the world's strongest women, and female weightlifters received little to no recognition for their hard work. Now, that hardly seems fair, doesn't it? No, it wasn't. And Judy Glenny would not stand for it. With a backbone as strong as the rest of her, she stood up for what she believed in. Of course, it wasn't easy, and the early women lifters had to fight against prejudice and many other terrible factors. But eventually, it became the juggernaut that it is today. Judy is on this list because she fought tirelessly to be recognized in the sport she loved, and her long list of accomplishments is a testament to that fact. She may not be the world's strongest woman anymore, but she was once, and not just physically. She is one of weightlifting's most prominent icons, and it is all boiled down to her firm determination. She had to fight her way to the top, and along with so many other women, she made it. The world of women's weightlifting would not have looked the same today if she wasn't around to spur it on. We should dedicate a day to her, where we all get the day off and talk about weightlifting or something. Iris Kyle. Have you ever been crowned as the greatest at anything? Maybe you're the greatest Wii player, or the greatest subtweeter. And not that those aren't legitimate callings, but I'd like to introduce you to the greatest IFBB professional female bodybuilder ever. Ladies and gentlemen, please say hello to Iris Kyle, probably the most iconic female bodybuilder ever. Her physique could put a lot of male bodybuilders to shame, and her passion for her sport knows no bounds. Affectionately known as Iron Maiden, Olympia, and Game Over, that should be a clear indication of strength right there. I mean, my enemies call me a runaway and cries girl, so she must be impressive. Anyway, so far, she is the single most successful female bodybuilder in the world, and she has won the title of Miss Olympia 10 times. After all that, they should just name the award after her. She has also won the Miss International Championship 7 times. And if that wasn't enough, she also owns a gym and co-owns a nutritional supplement store in Las Vegas. Can we just name a superhero after her already? Despite all her successes, what makes her a truly great bodybuilder is her dedication and commitment. You see it on her face as she competes. She loves what she is doing, and she has worked very hard to get to where she is today. And that is something that nobody can take away from her. Donna Moore. The World's Strongest Woman contest took a break in 2003, leaving women to find another competition to prove their worth. It started up again in 2016, and one woman stood above the rest and proved her might. That woman's name was Donna Moore, and she won a total of 5 events at the competition, surpassing Kristen Rhodes, who only won 3. This is the crowning jewel of her career, and we can only imagine the feeling of elation as she achieved the highest honor in her beloved sport. Thanks to her hard work, she now holds the title as the world's strongest woman. This is just the beginning, and we know that this female powerhouse has a lot more up her sleeve in the years to come. After all, it takes a special kind of person to emerge victorious after facing some of the most powerful women in the world. What makes this victory all the more impressive is the fact that she only won her first competition in 2012 at her local gym. This means that a relative newcomer to the world of professional lifting beat women who had been competing back when she was still watching TV on weekends. And if you doubt her talents, just remember that she pulled a 19-ton airplane in Norway. Your arguments are invalid. And there you have it. The 10 strongest women in the world. Were you surprised by any of the entries on our list? Let us know in the comments below. And don't forget to subscribe. Thanks!